you want to be the man, you got to beat the man.
I will beat Bobby Gill.
This out of control.
I will have the support of my team.
Some definite rivalry shaping up here for the championship series.
I don't know what 75's problem is.
Mr. Ross just really enjoyed my rear end there. I just made a new friend.
Bobby Gill leading Stephen Christian, who's looking all over the back of him. Contact with Gill. Stephen Christian weaving and wobbling all over the front, and look at there.
We'll have fun in the championship series.
If I wasn't going to win, he wasn't going to win the race.
That takes a lot of courage.
This week we're in my backyard. He said, to beat the man, you got to beat the man, so I guess I'm coming.
Gentlemen, start your engines.
And with those words from Guy Hamby, the 2003 season of the Hooters Pro Cup Series is underway. Hello and welcome, everyone, to USA International Speedway in Lakeland, Florida, for the Naturally Fresh Foods 250, presented by Advanced Discount Auto Parts. It is round one of the Southern Division and of the entire season. I'm Brian Drebber, along with Gene Crane in the booth as usual. And downstairs on pit road is Mr. Doug Rice. As we get ready to go racing here and dry out the track, let's go to Doug right now.
Guys, there are 37 cars lined up behind me here tonight at Lakeland to kick off the 2003 season. But some of our biggest stories involve drivers and teams who are absent tonight. And that includes 14-time winner from last season and three-time champion Bobby Gill. He's not here. Bobby injured his left shoulder racing in the Snowball Derby at Pensacola, had to have rotator cuff surgery. He could miss 6 to 7 races to open up the season. Also absent tonight, the defending Pro Cup champion, Jason Sarvis. Apparently, Jason has reached an impasse with Ricky Benton Racing about his contract, so he decided to sit the first one out. Also absent, Clay Rogers. You might remember that Clay made a serious run at the championship late last year. He's not here, but it's rumored that Clay is in line to take over a quality NASCAR Busch Series ride. Also absent tonight, Hal Goodson, but look for Hal to show up when the series enters its northern swing. Apparently, he'll run the Northern Division this season. And finally, Toby Robertson, who regularly campaigned in the red number 23 last year. He's here tonight. That's good news, but he's on top of the pit box. He returns as a car owner and a crew chief, and he'll have Matt Carter, the son of Winston Cup's Travis Carter, behind the wheel of his number 23. A lot of changes heading into the new season, and it really leaves it wide open for somebody else to step in and fill the void of some very big shoes. So, Brian and Gene, what do you think as we kick off the 2003 years? Who do you like?
Well, you have to like guys like Stephen Christian and those who are here. Thanks to Doug Rice for the truant list, I guess, Gene. And after a rain delay, we're going to get going here in just a few minutes. The car's going to be sent around to help finish drying off the racetrack. Earlier, Doug Rice spoke to our pole award winner.
Almost every driver has a goal at the start of the season. It's usually win a race, win a pole. Stacy Puryear, you took care of winning a pole right out of the box. You're on the front row here at Lakeland.
Yeah, I'm real excited. We never anticipated being able to run this good right out of the box with a brand new car, brand new team. Great new sponsors on board were Bryant and Winn-Dixie and also Golden Corral. And got to thank Advance Auto Parts for putting up this new pole award for this year, and tickled to be on the front row.
You told me earlier you felt like this could be a breakout year for you. This is a great start.
It sure is. You know, we just need to capitalize on what momentum we've gained right now and just keep the ball rolling.
Stacy Puryear's number 11 will roll off number one here tonight at Lakeland.
Great to see Stacy pick up that sponsorship. That team has been on the verge of breaking out, like they said. Second career pole for Stacy Puryear at the Pro Cup Series.
Pretty iffy weather here this afternoon, as we mentioned, a rain delay, but we will get underway with racing, and let's take a look at the racetrack here at USA International. Gene?
3/4 mile in length, 14 degrees in the corners, 4 degrees of banking on the straightaway. This track has dried very well after the afternoon shower that came through immediately after qualifying was complete this afternoon. So the track has dried out pretty well, although I hear we will start with a green and yellow condition.
Our Jack Russo's starting grid. You met the pole sitter, Stacy Puryear. Alongside him will be Mario Gosselin, trying to be super once again in 2003. Then it's Shane Wallace out of Mooresville, North Carolina, alongside last year rookie contender Joe Gaeta.
Toby Porter will take the Irmo grading 16 from the fifth starting position, and Danny Sammons, Northern competitor in his number 97, starts alongside Steve Christian in a number two. Number change this year, the Lucas Oil Chevy, and Sean Studer in the Carl Budding Meats Chevrolet on the outside.
Mike Laughlin Jr. goes in a Ford. They're carrying Griffin Thermal on the hood. Billy Mowry in the Precision Tool and Mold Chevy Monte Carlo alongside him. Then it's number 92, Mark Nesbitt, in the Coca-Cola Chevy Monte Carlo. He'll start alongside rookie Matt Carter in the Spevco Monte Carlo.
Bill Plemons Jr. back in action. He'll start on the inside of row number 7 in the Hooters Ford. He is joined by Shane Huffman in the Genio Turkey Store Ford on the outside. Michael Rich, the only Dodge in the field, Jack Roussos's number 28. And David Pletcher back in action in his Mobire Motorsports Ford.
Then it's rookie Danny O'Quinn Jr. out of Coburn, Virginia in the Homestead Trailer Chevy. Derek Kelly in the familiar number 21. He'll run up north, but he's going to start here tonight in the Advance Auto Parts Monte Carlo. Chad Mullis in the Mullis Well Drilling Ford, and Andrew Medlin, a great young driver in the Anaco Electrical Construction Ford, start side by side.
Florida drivers make up row number 11. Luke Hill in the number 41 out of Safety Harbor, and local favorite Keith Rogan out of Winter Haven, the Southern Road Builders number 94. Tony Amico, another Florida driver, starts 23rd in the 07 Caddy's Beach Bar Chevrolet, and Doug Stevens starts the Jasper Engines and Transmissions Ford alongside.
Then it's David Stover on row number 13 out of Tulsa, Oklahoma, in the Shaw Industries Chevy. Ronnie Davidson in the CNT Classic entry. Dandy Don Satterfield in the Hawksaw Blades, familiar number 1. J.P. Morgan, a rookie out of Ether, North Carolina, in the CrewSchool.com Chevy.
Corey Rubel will make his first start in the Pro Cup Series from position number 29. He is joined in the 15th row by Vince Fenevo out of Livonia, Georgia. Mike Williams out of Conover, North Carolina, starts the 24 on the inside of row number 16. And on the outside, Todd Hirschfeld in the 68, the next tip for.
We'll finish up the field with Brian Finney in the Bob Steele Chevrolet. Mikey Stafford, a rookie out of Georgia. And Royce Johnston, also a rookie. And finally, Michael Strother will take the last start position. Doug Rice's count was off by one because Larry Barrett, while he took qualifying, did not make the start. We're on board with Stephen Christian in the number 2. That'll take a while to get used to, but it is the Lucas Oil Products Black's Tire entry. Number 25, David Stover in the Shaw Industries car will also be carrying it on board. You'll be riding with him time to time during the evening here tonight. And off the back of the number 28 of Michael Rich, the Jackaroo Sauces car will give you a great view of most of the field at this point, because he starts in the number 15 spot. With a wave of the green and yellow, Dr. Guy Hamby, who is also the crew chief of the Naturally Fresh Hot Air Balloon, doing double duty here tonight, both as the starter and the grand marshal. So about, they're gonna try to finish drying off the track here with the race cars, Gene, and that's a good way to do it. So while the cars circle around the racetrack and get that last little bit of moisture off the track, we will take a break and be right back to start them up.
USAR Hooters Pro Cup Racing is brought to you by Hooters, the cure for the common restaurant. Jackaroo Sauces. Try Jackaroo Sauces at your next cookout. Jackaroo is served in America's finest backyard. Miller Lite. Grab a Miller Lite. It's Miller time. Lucas Oil Products. Lucas Oil Products is a leader in heavy-duty and high-performance lubricant.
The rain has gone away and we're ready to go racing.
So take it away, Brian and Gene.
Thank you very much, girls. And the fans in the stands are kind of peeling out of their raincoats here after some precipitation. We actually had a jet vehicle out here to help dry the track a little bit. And now that the cars have finished the job, we're going to wave the green flag for real. Yeah, they're on their feet. And here we go once again. Guy Hamby, this time with only the green flag. 15 laps under yellow to count, and we are racing behind pole sitter Stacy Perrier.
On the outside, the 1997 Hooters Pro Cup Series champion Mario Goslin trying to challenge Perrier as they charge down to turn number 3. Shane Wallace and Joe Gaeta, pretty good side-by-side battle as they start work off the fourth turn and complete lap number 1.
Perrier 8 thousandths of a second quicker than Goslin in qualifying, and he's a car length ahead of him right now as he holds on to the lead. Goslin falls in line. He's still given a nudge and a bump every now and then as Wallace has also fallen in line, leaving Joe Gaeta up on the outside. Those two have not settled the issue for who's going to run third.
Pretty good battle for that third spot. looks like Goslin, who will run a part-time schedule, at least for the time being, in the Pro Cup Series Southern Division in 2003, settles against that second spot of Stacey Currier, where he wants to be right now, out front and leading here early in the 2003 campaign.
Lead four cars have opened a little bit of a gap on the fifth place, number 16 machine, Toby Porter, the Irmo grading entry. There's Gata on the outside of Wallace, who simply does not want to surrender either the inside line or the number three spot on the racetrack. And now Porter starting to close the gap and get up there and make it five cars in the front group.
Shane Wallace proved that he had a lot of horsepower underneath the hood of that Ford, and he is really showing it tonight. He ran well when we were at Concord last year, late in the season, racing with Bobby Gill. Now he'll get the better of Joe Gata in turn one.
Pretty big void as Gill is not here. Ronnie Davidson takes the CNT Classic number six down on pit road under green. That's never good. We'll try to get an update on that as Stephen Christian in the Lucas Oil Products entry is also trying to get up there and join the leaders. Purrier starting to edge away just a little bit, but has put a clear couple of car lengths between himself and Goslin.
We've seen Mike Williams take his car down to pit road. Problem with that car during practice with a harmonic balancer. Looks like it has put the 24 out of contention tonight. Leader continues to be Purrier in that Bryant. Actually, that's a Chevrolet. Everybody has changed makes and models this year. There's a lot of things to tell you about the changes that have happened in teams and makes and models. And, of course, 2003, a new body concept coming into play in the Pro Cup Series.
Well, we're not the only ones, and we'll try to update you on everything that is going on as Christian is still trying to pedal that next group up to join the leaders. There he is, just coming into view. As Stephen Christian has to be one of the favorites here tonight with all the absentees, Christian running so well last season. And now we're getting a challenge on the inside as Goslin puts a fender on Purrier down low. He's got the position and a little bit of perhaps contact. In any case, Goslin got loose. He is nosed ahead and maybe, no, I don't think he made it across the line with the nose of that car to take a lead lap.
Got it turn one though. Looks like Goslin is going to get the advantage on Purrier, and that'll leave the old pole open for Wallace to follow through. Looks like Gata's going to drop down and try it as well when they get to turn three.
So Purrier's duration at the front was only a few laps, and now he's gone all the way back to third spot. He's just a little bit higher on the racetrack there for a moment than Gata, but now he drops in line. Our leader is now Super Mario. We were calling him So-So Mario last year because he was having very un-Goslin-like performances. We're certainly hopeful that Mario can... Oh, we got a spin as the 51 car goes around. David Buggy Pletcher, without any damage apparently, is sideways, backwards, and now facing the correct direction on the racetrack. And in all that, Shane Wallace takes the lead.
Actually, Shane will have to fall back in line. They'll revert back to the last completed green flag lap in Pro Cup Racing. Here's the Coca-Cola replay as to what happened to David Buggy Pletcher. And can't really see a lot of it there, Brian, but it looks like he may have got the car off on the flat and just lost it.
Bottomed it out a little bit, so the fans are on their feet. Here is the one lap ago running order. Goslin will be the leader. Shane Wallace, second place. Pole sitter Stacey Purrier in third. We'll be right back here to USA International to continue the Naturally Fresh Foods 250. Welcome back to USA International as Mike Williams briefly went back out onto the racetrack to see if it was his imagination about the harmonic balancer. It was not.
No, it definitely was. I spoke with him during practice. It's been an ongoing problem all race day long during practice, trying to find another balancer to go on that motor, but to no avail, and looks like it may be the end of the night for Mike Williams.
Some great fans in the stands here at USA International as the cars are circling the racetrack behind Mario Goslin. The pace car is down on pit road, and we're going back to the green flag here, 30 laps in to the Naturally Fresh Foods 250.
Looks like Mario gets a pretty good start on that restart, gets a couple of car lengths on Shane Wallace.
Our Naturally Fresh Field summary, Goslin, Wallace, and Purrier. Stephen Christian running in sixth position with a whole bunch of cars behind him that he's trying to drag up there, and he's down on the inside right now. Goslin leads a quartet of cars, and everybody else trying to get up there and join the party. Oh yeah, that sounds good. Lean your head right out over the wall and listen to them when they go by.
Haven't said a lot about the 16 car with Toby Porter on board running fifth right now. Kind of a quiet run. They're running right between those two packs right now. Toby, just a little more than 24 hours ago, had no idea he'd be here driving that race car. Last minute decision by Haskell Willingham to put Toby Porter out of Greenville, South Carolina in the car. They showed up and have done a great job so far this evening.
Danny Salmon's moving up and around Stephen Christian there with Sean Studer behind him now. So Salmon's heading towards the front with a good run here in the early laps of the race. He started sixth, and he's parked right up there in that position right now.
beginning his third year of competition in the Pro Cup Series and starting to see the maturity come around. Danny Sammons, a two-time quarter midget champion, as is his brother, starting to get the feel of these race cars. If you recall back about Salem of last season, things really turned around for that program, and they are on a roll and running very well. He'll compete in the North once again in 2003.
A good look there at Michael Rich in the Jackaroo Sauces car, and now Derek Kelly in the 21. We go back up front with Mario Gosselin in the familiar number 10. Shane Wallace having a good run and starting to look like challenging Gosselin for the lead. He took it briefly in that earlier caution, but they went back to scoring in the previous lap. He's got to settle in and do it all over again. Meanwhile, Joe Gaeta, who technically was a rookie last year, is now technically a veteran, and we've known that's how it is all along. We got another caution, and the 31 car got together back there with another car. Vince Finello in the 31 has turned around. It was also the 23 involved of rookie Matt Carter. So a pair of rookie drivers getting together and bringing out another caution here at USA International.
You see the damage on the right front of Matt Carter's Spevco Chevrolet, so they'll need to take a look at that and make sure it's not rubbing the right front tire.
Hey, wake that kid up. Well, he did have to sit through a long rain delay, but there's a lot of exciting racing yet to come here at USA International. The Naturally Fresh Foods 250, presented by Advanced Discount Auto Parts, is race number one of the 2003 season in Hooters Pro Cup action here. Welcome back once again to USA International. Ryan Drever and Gene Crane upstairs, Doug Rice downstairs, Mario Gosselin leading Shane Wallace to the green flag on lap number 39.
Once again, Mario Gosselin gets the jump on the restart. Wallace falls back about 2.5 car lengths, but directly behind Stacy Puryear, Joe Gaeta, along with Toby Porter, your top five. See that remainder of the Naturally Fresh top 10 rundown there. Mike Laughlin Jr. on the march, on board with Stephen Christian and the Lucas Oil Products Chevrolet. Make sure we say Chevrolet this year. That's what he's driving for 2003, although you've got a feeling there may be a Ford in the works over at RBR.
Looking forward to all of the lead cars there. And now as we go to the outside, Gaeta ducking down for a little look down low. That's Toby Porter coming up behind him right now in that relatively plain white wrapper car number 16. As you mentioned, the Irmo grading entry was kind of a last-minute situation here this weekend, as were many. Of course, you get the season started. You got butterflies to get rid of and sponsors to get on board, and lots of things are going on. We heard a report from Doug Rice at the beginning about some of the significant drivers who are not here, but we are among those who are racing here tonight, and right now it's Mario Gosselin who's got the measure of the field.
Not a surprise. Mario Gosselin, particularly from about 97 through about 99, really dominated in terms of wins that he placed in the column in racing action here at USA International Speedway, whether it was late models or Hooters Pro Cup. He was very strong.
So Gosselin leads the race. Shane Wallace in second position along with Bobby Gill. Yes, Mario Gosselin defined Hooters Pro Cup racing not long ago. We talked to him earlier.
We're in Lakeland, so Mario Gosselin must be somewhere around. Mario, what are your plans for 2003?
Right now we're looking for sponsorship. You know, we got these boys out of Pennsylvania got me to drive this thing, and we're going to try to run enough to stay in the points. Hopefully we get a sponsorship, run them all. You know, right now we know we can do two or three and kind of go from there.
All right, you need a couple of things to go racing: fuel and money, and you're looking for the latter, right?
Well, with the money we can get the fuel.
Good point, Mario. And yeah, I guess Mario Gosselin would be on anybody's short list of race car drivers for Hooters Pro Cup. If he's available, somebody's going to go out there and try to get him.
Been subject to a lot of questions over the last 2 years because Mario has been on a part-time schedule trying to get all the pieces to come together, and certainly hope this is a program that will, you know, prove to be a good one for 2003 and have him at least most of the Southern races, and then of course the championship series. Shane Wallace, the number four, looking very, very strong here in the early going, and as I noted earlier at Concord late in the season, he and Bobby Gill had a heck of a battle for the win there, Bobby getting the best of it, but Shane serving notice here tonight that he's ready to go in 2003.
Going around the 31 of rookie Vince Finello involved in that earlier incident, the leaders definitely got into some traffic there, and the move over flag has been waving pretty vigorously. A lot of the cars have indeed stepped aside to allow the leaders to come by, and yes, Shane Wallace is challenging Mario Gosselin around the racetrack right now as they continue to work traffic. They have one more lap car in front of them right now, and they'll have some clear racetrack for a bit.
Looks like Stacy Puryear settled into that third spot. content to be there right now. Gata, who was quick in practice, he was the fastest car during practice earlier this afternoon. He is set right in that fourth spot, not making any attempt to move up to the front and lead a lap as of yet. And of course, right now is when the point battle begins. You want to get your car as far up in the points as you can to try to help that weighting system that will help with an advantage, point advantage, in the five championship series races to decide that $1 million championship point fund money distribution. Here's a challenge, Wallace to the inside of Goslin over in three.
And slow moving car, Buggy Pletcher down on the bottom. Really, I think Goslin kind of checked up and moved up, and that gave Shane Wallace a free run down on the inside. They had worked around Ronnie Davidson, the CNT Classic car, that was fighting as hard as he could to keep from going a lap down. Once he finally did, then they ran into some additional problems. And Shane Wallace has really stepped away, and now coming through on the inside is also the number 11 of pole sitter Stacy Puryear, who slipped back a couple of spots. Now he's moving forward again.
Looks like Goslin moved up to the high side to breathe just a little bit, not abuse them. And speaking of Goodyear, here's our Goodyear full field rundown at lap number 50.
Toby Porter still rounding out the top five with Joe Gata just in front of him. Mike Laughlin Jr. in sixth position, Shane Huffman rounding out the top 10. And once again, Ronnie Davidson's going to take the number six down to pit road as we continue to look at the Goodyear full field rundown. A lot of rookie drivers, new names to get used to this year. O'Quinn there, and here's a trio of them. Carter Stover and Hirschfield running in the 21st to 25th position. Four rookies in the next five, and Dandy Don Satterfield and the Hawksaw Blades number one among them. Pletcher having mechanical problems. Struther and Finello among the issues here tonight, too. Williams out of the race, along with Ronnie Davidson now, who has apparently pulled the CNT Classic number six time tonight.
And Brian Finney on the original start, having some difficulties. That car being down on pit road, a numerous number of laps has him well down in the standings right now. Certainly he'll begin to inch his way back up as the laps wear on for that second generation driver.
Word coming to us now that Buggy Pletcher, David Pletcher in the Mobar Motorsports Pletcher Racing Engines Ford is out for the evening as well. As we go on board with Stephen Christian, who's just riding right now, it seems like. He hasn't really made any very aggressive moves one way or the other, and he's just riding behind the leaders.
Smart thing to do. Only 50 laps have been put in the book, so we've still got a long way to go. It's a green racetrack. Torrential rains here delaying this event. Finally getting underway about 10:30 at night here in Lakeland, Florida. So, yeah, it's a smart thing to do, to sit back there and bide your time. No sense using up the race car early on.
Well, a very patient driver, Stephen Christian, and that's exactly what he's doing. Shane Wallace, the leader, is definitely edged away. Puryear's going after him. Goslin is now just riding. And Gata taking a page out of Bobby Gill's book, just looking for a big empty spot on the racetrack and biding his time as well.
Speaking of Bobby Gill, it was Bobby Gill who took Gata battle all race long in that season finale here at USA International Speedway, only to come home second. He went to school, although this veteran really doesn't need to go to school very often. Went to school on Bobby and really did a pretty good job. There is a shot of the Stover and Finello. Whoa, hang on there,
hang
Vince.
On. Vince Finello is hanging on, but finally let it go as he goes around, and that's going to bring out another caution here. 56 laps in to the Naturally Fresh Foods 250. So we'll take a little bit of breather. Hope you can do the same, and then come on back and join us. Hi, girls, and welcome back to the Naturally Fresh Foods 250. Let's go downstairs to Doug Rice.
Caught up with Darren Shaw, crew chief for Shane Wallace. Your guy started third, and you've moved to the point here. What's he telling you about the car?
He says right now the car's driving like a Cadillac, so he's when he says that, he's pretty darn happy, and he's doing a really good job tonight, keep himself clean, and there ain't a scratch on the car yet, and he's in the lead now, so he's done everything he can to get us in this position.
Darren, do you guys have an early game plan on when you might make your pit stop tonight?
We're going to pit somewhere around 150, I hope. If we got a yellow somewhere around there, that's when we're going to do it. We don't want to stretch it much farther than that. But you never tell what we can do if we get a yellow at 135.
Always playing them close to the vest, these crew chiefs out there. But, you know, pit stop strategy is fairly obvious in Hooters Pro Cup racing. You have to make one stop, and it's a good idea if you're up front to stay out until after halfway.
Good opportunity to point out that really as far as pit strategy and pit stops are concerned by the rule book in 2003. No changes, still eight tires allotted to each team for the course of the 250 laps. You must come to pit road and change at least two tires at some point during the event. That's pretty much everything in a nutshell on the pit stops. And it all comes down to the strategy by these crew chiefs and what games they're able to play with each other and trying to get that fuel window and keep the freshest tires on those race cars.
Shane Wallace out front with Stacy Puryear, who started from the pole. Mario Gosselin back two or three car lengths. Joe Gaeta right behind him, poised and ready to strike at any time. The 97 of Danny Sammons, who will race in the Northern Division for the bulk of the season, getting a first toe in the water here by coming to the season opener at Lakeland in that 97 car. Fred's Trailer Service, Hallmark.com for Taurus.
Noticing just a little bit of smoke out of the 7 car, Mike Laughlin Jr., when he picks up on the throttle in the middle of the corner. I don't know if we'll get a chance to see it. There is Steve Christian and a brand new paint job that we're trying to get used to here in 2003. Here we go with the race car for Christian and the number 2.
A lot of things to get used to, and some of them just since the cars rolled out of the trailer, some of them look very different now than they did when they first got here. I mean, guys were scrambling at the last minute. We had a lot of plain cars, a lot of generic automobiles that got stickered up and numbered after they got to the racetrack this afternoon.
And a few of those situations, in fact, one in particular, not really by choice. Andrew Medlin had his primary car destroyed before he even got half a lap on the racetrack. The spinning car came off the track in turn number 2 and collected his car, destroyed the primary car. They had to go to a backup, and he's not doing too badly right now. He's in the top 20, qualified 20th. He's moving towards the top 10, not quite there yet, but maybe we'll get a chance and see Andrew in just a little bit. They had to bring the plain white wrapper backup that was there for either himself or Hirschfeld to drive, and unfortunately it was Medlin, who's now a second-year driver of the Pro Cup, that had to pull the backup car into use.
Gosselin seems to have lost the handle just a little bit on the number 10 car. He lost a spot to Joe Gaeta, who felt like he just had to get around Gosselin. Too much of a gap had opened up in front of the 10 car to the leaders, so Gaeta went around, and now it's the number 16 of Toby Porter knocking on the door. So clearly Gosselin's car was good earlier, and it's looked like a little loose coming off the corner there, and he's definitely losing a half a tenth or so per lap.
Mario had to pitch the car down to the bottom side as Michael Struther, the number 3, is running around the top side. That team has struggled mightily all weekend long. In fact, not getting to the racetrack till late in the practice session earlier this afternoon after the trailer broke down on the way down to Florida. So he's had his share of troubles trying to stay out of harm's way here tonight at Lakeland.
That's in the Lone Star Motorsports number 3, Struther out of Thomasville, North Carolina. And he's going to get a black flag now because he's just going too slowly around the top of the track there for the USAR officials to leave him out there much longer. So he spent so much time working on the race hauler that he didn't get the race car quite quick enough. As Porter now looking underneath and getting plenty of opportunities to make a pass here fairly soon on Gosselin, who's really struggling behind the wheel of the 10.
And the car does look to be a little loose out. Last time out of turn 4, you can see the car try to jump a little bit. This time it stays in line. Mario drives it down to the bottom side, trying to make Toby run the outside line if he was going to get around. Now they'll go nose to tail in turns 1 and 2. And again, Goslin's car right in the middle of the corner. When he picks up the throttle, it wants to jump sideways. So Gosselin fighting some handling problems in that number 10 as Toby Porter looks to the inside.
And Porter might have enough room to get by the number 10 Brooks Automotive Group Monte Carlo of Gosselin. The big problem is the huge gap that opens in front of Gosselin. So if you're behind him and can't pass him quickly and efficiently, the leaders get away. So Porter sees the opportunity now, and it took him a while to do so. But if he can run the pace of the leaders, or maybe even a little bit faster, he'll be able to re-catch them, if you want to call it that, as Gosselin is just fading back one spot after another.
It's almost as if Mario moved up the racetrack and let Toby go. Here comes Danny Sammons up to challenge the now third-year driver, like I said earlier, in that 97N. Bill Boger helping to call the shots on that car, and they have really come around. That team is looking strong for 2003, the Northern campaign. There's a handful of drivers that, quite honestly, at the end of this season, if we haven't seen them in victory lane, I'm going to be surprised. Sammons is one of the drivers I'd put on that list.
A look at number 66, rookie Royce Johnston there, and back to the leader Shane Wallace in the number 4 car. Michael Struther taking the Lone Star Motorsports entry down. He had come in for the black flag, but now we're hearing that he lost his brakes, so he just had to kind of get out of the gas and roll slowly. Now it says Pontiac on the back of this car, Gene, but he entered a Chevrolet.
Well, that's what our entry list shows. Apparently, they have had a tough weekend trying to get that car not only here to the racetrack, but getting it around the racetrack. Wallace in heavy traffic. Hirschfeld up on the outside of the 68, and directly ahead of them is Corey Rubel in the 73, making his first start in the Pro Cup Series.
Rubel looking for a sponsor and an opportunity to run for Rookie of the Year honors. You got another slow-moving race car up around the top, and that's Billy Mowry, the number 33, the Precision Tool and Mold Chevy Monte Carlo, also rolling slowly. Now he's picked up the pace just ever so slightly, but he's definitely got a problem.
Brian, the way that car's crabbing, yeah. It looks like something's wrong with the rear end. Yep. Looks like a track bar.
I would have to say,
like. Yeah.
Because the car's kind of pointed northeast while he's trying to get it north around the racetrack. He'll definitely come to the attention of his crew down pit road now.
Shane Wallace still in command, and look at Mowry trying to wrestle that thing down onto the pit road. He's got it down on the safety apron to make that turn onto pit road, but Wallace looks like he's checking out a pretty good advantage for our leader, Shane Wallace.
Shane Wallace running out of trouble while Billy Mowry has run into some. Something has definitely come loose out from underneath the number 33 race car. While Shane Wallace is in traffic a little bit, and it looks like we're going to see a caution on the racetrack because there's something laying there. Doug Rice, what's up with 33?
Billy Mowry slowly makes his way into his pit stall in the number 33 Monte Carlo, and he either possibly has a loose trailing arm or possibly a sway bar that is broken on the car. The crew's going around to the backside of the number 33 machine and try to effect repairs, but Mowry's had a myriad of problems tonight on the racetrack, and meanwhile, the yellow is out here at Lakeland.
So while the crew goes to look underneath the car, the USAR officials are having a look around the track. It seems as though they found a bolt, probably from Mowry's car. The Naturally Fresh Foods 250, presented by Advanced Discount Auto Parts, continues at USA International in Lakeland, Florida, here to start the 2003 season of Hooters Pro Cup action. Brian Drever, Gene Crane, and Doug Rice doing the honors for you at home as the cars are lined up. Some of the others heading towards the front as a round of pit stops has certainly taken place here. Some of the drivers deciding to come down, make some adjustments, take on tires early. But for Shane Wallace, of course, he's going to stay out there. The car's nearly perfect. Nobody's challenged him, and he takes him to green on lap 82.
This time Wallace with a little bit of a challenge right now from Stacy Puryear. Gets a good run off of turn number two. Puts some distance between himself and Puryear. Joe Gaeta up to third. And Danny Sam is on the challenge right now. He's to the inside of Toby Porter.
There's that puff of smoke coming out of the number seven of Mike Laughlin Jr., the group here in the Crocs. Ford Taurus continues to puff away every now and then when he stands on the gas. Not sure, maybe they overfilled the sump a little bit or something. Where, you know, it doesn't seem to be causing a problem, and it has not caused any concern on the part of the officials. Three cars slipping away from the rest of the field. Sammons, who has now gotten around into fourth position, may be able to close the gap, but on the restart, he lost some ground.
See Mikey Stafford up on the high side in car number 72. We've got cars that started on the inside line. They were lap cars, so they lined up on the bottom side. These leaders having to negotiate around those lap cars as they start to put some more laps up on the board.
That black and green number 71 belongs to Sean Studer. We saw a lot of him in Hooters Pro Cup action a couple of seasons ago. He's now back in the Carl Buddick Meets Chevy Monte Carlo. Running among the leaders. There he goes, and we're on board now with David Stover running in 20th position, carrying an onboard camera for us here. Stover in the number 25 car, the Shaw Industries Monte Carlo.
It's Doug Stevens directly ahead with his Jasper Engines Ford.
Nice and smooth on and off the throttle now as Gaeta starting to challenge Puryear just a little bit. And Joe Gaeta riding a very patient race right now, as have a couple of the other more veteran drivers. And while we have made much of Joe Gaeta's run for Miller Lite Rookie of the Year honors in 2002, he is right where he ought to be, and that is one of the veterans, because he is.
Well, he is a veteran, 20-year plus behind the wheel up throughout the seaboard section of Virginia, actually all over the East Coast. He's going to make a move to the inside of Puryear down in turn number three, and Stacy Puryear swings from the outside down to the bottom and closes the door. But Joe Gaeta, 1 year ago, hadn't planned on going racing much at all, if at all, and got a call to climb on board the 06. He was actually helping his son with his racing program at Langley Speedway. Got the call and has made it work.
So Joe Gaeta riding on a rail down around the bottom while Puryear is a little bit loose up on top, and Puryear finally says, okay, fine, you've got the faster car. I was pretending not there for a lap or two, but okay, Joe, have at him. I'm just gonna have to wait and ride and not lose too many spots, hopefully, until we can get down and make some adjustments on this number 11 car.
That's exactly the pole. That's exactly the point, Brian. An opportunity to come to pit road, bolt on four fresh Goodyear Eagles, make an adjustment in air pressure. These are bias ply tires, so adjust the stagger a little bit, get that car to handle, and off we go racing again. Here's Chad Bumas on the inside as he is going to challenge the 25 of Stover. Pretty good race going on there at turn number three.
Well, we always look for the better races on the track, and when we find one, we go back and show it to you as we're on board with Stover now as Mullis in the Mullis Well Drilling Ford Taurus goes by him. Good little battles all over the racetrack, and they heat up a little bit right off the restarts. There you can see Mullis in the 9 starting to pull away from that 25 car, and Shane Wallace pulling away from everybody.
Mullis does have it on cruise control right now. Now the question is, can the crew make the right call and make the stop work for Shane Wallace when it comes time to get some service, get some fresh Goodyear Eagles and a load of Sunoco race fuel on that race car.
Just a second back to this battle for second place there, or back to second place Joe Gaeta in the battle for third as Puryear is now falling into the clutches of Danny Sammons, and it is Puryear like Gosselin, and there we see Mario, that has lost the spots from the beginning of the race, giving up positions on the racetrack to cars that are a little faster as the laps wind up. Toby Porter on the number 16 heading forward or holding his own at this point. The 7 of Mike Laughlin Jr. in spite of a puff of smoke every now and then. And there comes the 2. And that is Stephen Christian. It's going to take us a while to get used to seeing a 2 on the side of the Buford, Georgia driver's Lucas Oil car.
I tell you, Studer there, we see him in the 71, the Budding-sponsored Chevrolet. We've seen him go to victory lane 3 times carrying the Naturally Fresh logo. New sponsorship on the side of that Chevrolet. That team's looking for a lot of good things. Then we see Shane Huffman. Rounds out our top 10. That Genio Turkey Store Ford is actually a 2003 body. We'll hear a little more about the 2003 configuration of body styles and a common greenhouse coming into play. And there is Bill Clements Jr. starting to put the pressure on the 92. And who is the 92?
Martin Esmond. Another one we're going to have a little bit of a problem getting used to. Apparently, 92 is a significant number to him earlier in his racing career. That's the number he ran, and it became available this year, and he took it. So the 15 of the Warrior, Bill Clements Jr., driving the number 15 car back there, the Hooters Ford Taurus. Here we go to this battle with Toby Porter in the 16 car that we're used to seeing on the side of Stephen Christian's entry. Now he's the 2. The 10 of Gosselin's behind him, and there is the number 2 of Stephen Christian just behind the familiar 7 of Mike Laughlin Jr. We're on board with Stephen Christian. They all go around the outside of rookie Royce Johnston in that turquoise color, number 66. We might get a look. There's a little of that puff of smoke just as he gets back in the gas. Apparently there's just a little bit of a, you know, the vacuum created when he gets out of the gas is drawing a little bit of oil up past the piston rings and, you know, symptoms perhaps of an engine not quite broken in yet, maybe.
And we saw Steve Christian in that number 2 car just a little nudge on the rear bumper as they exited the corner.
Shane Wallace, you can see he has led since lap 49. He took the lead briefly, but scoring reverted to the previous lap, and Gosselin was given the chance that Wallace passed him for good, at least up until now. Gosselin continues to slip back a little bit. Puff of smoke once again out of Laughlin. No concern by Christian thus far, although he may be getting a spot or two on his windshield. He's just biding his time back there.
Handle continuing to go away just a little bit on Gosselin's car. He continues to struggle, and you can see that Toby Porter has been able to stretch it out. Mike Laughlin Jr. and now Steve Christian, who's going to take a look to the inside of Laughlin down at turn number 3. He's starting to mount a charge there. A little contact in the middle of the corner, but Laughlin slams the door shut out of turn 4.
Mike Laughlin Jr., one of the nicest guys you'll ever meet, unless he's behind the wheel of the race car. We got a problem. Our camera guys are swinging hard over to the other side of the track, and Mikey Stafford, rookie driver out of Ellabelle, Georgia, looking for a sponsor and an opportunity to run for Miller Lite Rookie of the Year honors, refires the race car, but we're under yellow. See you in a minute. The Naturally Fresh Foods 250, presented by Advanced Discount Auto Parts, continues much to the pleasure and enjoyment of the gathered fans of Hooters Pro Cup Racing. And we're glad you could join us here on Speed, the home of Hooters Pro Cup for 2003. New time, 7 p.m. Thursday, March 20th will be the next opportunity for you to enjoy great racing like this. The Hooters Pro Cup 250 from Five Flags Speedway in nearby, well, somewhat nearby, Pensacola, Florida, over on the Panhandle. If you can make it down there for the race, we'd love to see you. If not, join us here on your TNV.
First three events of 2003 for the Southern Division in Florida. We'll move back to New Smyrna Speedway on March the 29th. Second appearance for the Pro Cup Series along the east coast of Florida. Green is back out. Here is Wallace up through the gearbox, and Joe Gaeta giving chase as they head back to turn one. Let's see if Gaeta's got anything for him here as we get close to the halfway mark. Of course, bonus money available for the field as we look at all of them in our Goodyear full field rundown. Wallace, Gaeta there, the front two runners. Mike Laughlin Jr. and Stephen Christian with Shane Huffman just behind them. Bill Plemons Jr. in the number 15 Hooters car is right there. And how about the 07 there, Tony Amico, rookie driver, running up in 14th position. Another couple of rookies right behind him. Gosselin all the way back to 21st, just ahead of a quartet of rookies. Make that six of them, counting Stafford and Rubel in 26th and 27th position. Then we start to see some of the drivers who have had difficulties here tonight, including Billy Mowry and Mike Struther. Buggy Pletcher early in the race, and the first one out was the number 24, Mike Williams of the World Products Monte Carlo.
You know, I'm surprised.
Challenge
Billy
for the lead.
Big challenge. Gaeta to the bottom side of Wallace. The halfway money is up for grabs right now. Lucas Oil with $1,000 again to the leader at each and every event. Lap number 125, Gaeta wants that $1,000.
Oh, hey, the laps that count are at halfway and at 250. And so if you can make a grand, why not? Joe Gaeta nudges into the lead ahead of Shane Wallace across the line. He officially is the leader now in that number 06 automobile. The ACS Systems and Engineering Kimnock Ford Taurus. Wallace trying to come back at him now. We'll see if that was just a one-lap deal or whether Gaeta can hang on to it.
Looks like Joe's got that preferred line and able to keep that car nailed down to the bottom side. Shane Wallace now looks like he's going to wait just a couple of laps because we do have about a handful of laps, 10 laps or so before halfway coming up. Back to Mowry, the bolt that is on the front of the trailing arm came off that race car. That's what they picked up on the backstretch during that caution. And actually, Billy Mowry, very lucky the front of that trailing arm didn't drop down and dig in the asphalt. That could have been quite a tumble in that situation. I can guarantee that'll be checked when we head to Pensacola.
Let the record reflect that Joe Gaeta took the lead on lap 109. We got a little bit of a spank up against the wall. The number 68 just touched it. That's rookie Todd Hirschfeld in the next tip for Taurus. So he spanked the wall, did a little bit of a damage to his number 68 race car. Let's take a look at our Coca-Cola replay and what happened. Oh, looked like Tony Amico gave him a little nudge there, and Hirschfeld couldn't quite gather it up before he hit the wall.
Had the brakes locked down and the car would not turn. A little contact with the right front. Some of the leaders on pit road, Danny Sammons leading that group down pit road for service.
Danny Sammons deciding he wants to make some changes to his race car. He's not alone by any means. He's just the man furthest up to the front. He'll get to his pit box first. You can see that the Lucas Oil number 2 of Christian is down there, the 92 of Martin Nesbitt, among others. Everybody goes to work, including our Doug Rice.
Danny Sammons makes his pit stop here as we get close to the halfway point. 18 years old, not quite yet 19. One of the few Northern Series drivers here tonight at Lakeland has his Taurus on the pit lane. Right behind him, Stephen Christian's also making a pit stop. Some furious adjustments being made on the Christian number 2 machine. Meanwhile, the Sammons crew comes around to the left-hand side. They'll bolt on a couple of fresh Goodyears that will send him the rest of the way. Let's see if Sammons can get down and away before Stephen Christian. Down and away is Danny Sammons, and right behind him, Stephen Christian, as he makes his exit from the pit lane.
Okay, so a significant round of pit stops is down. Let's see how the... What is that guy thinking? We'll be right back. The Naturally Fresh Foods 250, presented by Advanced Discount Auto Parts, kicks off, starts off, waves the green flag on the 2003 season of Hooters Pro Cup Racing. Glad you could join us here at USA International Speedway in Lakeland, Florida. Traditional start and finish of the season takes place at this racetrack, partly and perhaps mostly this time of year because it's nice and warm down here. The weather's been a little iffy, though. Rain started out the day. The race was delayed a while, but once it got underway, it's been a good one. Joe Gaeta took the lead on lap 109. We go back to green here with the halfway mark looming in front of us.
Joe Gaeta looking to pick up the $1,000 at halfway, but more importantly, his first ever win in the Pro Cup Series. Likewise, for the four car right behind, Shane Wallace has yet to score a victory, but behind them, Perrier has one credit. I'd like to make it two.
Gaeta definitely a contender for a win last season. He followed Jason Sarvis home a couple of times. And here's Bobby Gibbs, three times more than that. But with
neither of them here. Gaeta has to be considered among the favorites, especially at Lakeland, where he had such a good run to end the season in 2002.
Saw briefly in that rundown, the Naturally Fresh rundown of the top 10, that we had Keith Rogan and Tony Amico running in the top 10. Good run for those Florida drivers, and a spin by Shane Huffman in the 84. He keeps on going.
No caution, and the Genio Turkey Store's number 84 just continues after losing a few spots. Gaeta and Wallace still running up front. No caution, as we mentioned. We're still racing here towards the halfway mark. And Joe Gaeta stretching out some room. A lot of shuffling in the running order because of pit stops, of course. And there were a handful of cars that stayed out. Those are among the top four or five on the track right now, including Toby Porter in the 16. And you're looking at your leader with just over a second advantage now.
Didn't quite see what happened to Huffman, but he was one of the cars that came to pit road and got a fresh set of Goodyear Eagles, cold tires, and possibly, and well, there's the 61 of J.P. Morgan. He might have been a part of it as well.
Fellow rookie number 66, Royce Johnston there. One of the guys who fell out is Derek Kelly, and he's with Doug Rice.
Derek Kelly, you had to park the Advance Auto Parts machine early tonight. What put you back here behind the wall?
Yeah, you know, we hate it. It's a terrible way to start a season. We have Discount Auto Parts still on board for a couple more races here, and then we're on our own. We just come out here. We're going to run the North Series this year. Come out here to get some seat time in this new car, and new parts are failing. So maybe I should have bought them at Discount Auto Parts. $10,000 worth of brakes, something happened to them. So next time I'm going to just go up Discount and get me a good set of brakes. I think that'll work better.
Tried to work his sponsor in there a couple of times. Great job, Derek Kelly. Now, tonight's race was not going to score any points in the Southern Division Championship point standing. He's elected to collect points in the North. Kind of unusual for a driver from right down the road from USA International Speedway.
Joe Gaeta collects the halfway leader prize from Lucas Oil Products. He only led 15 laps, but that one was worth $1,000. He'll put it in the bank and move on for the next 125 here in the Naturally Fresh Foods 250. Derek Kelly put a total of 81 laps in the book before he went out. The 28 of Michael Rich there in the Jackaroo car, also having a fairly decent run up towards the front now. He elected to stay out, improve his track position just a little bit. As we're looking at Rich leading Mario Gosselin, and bound to be under the next opportunity, a bunch of the leaders who stayed out will be coming in.
Expect those front runners now to just settle in and ride it out, wait for that opportunity to come to pit road, because there's absolutely nothing to be gained by racing too much up front. Save the tires, save the equipment, get a fresh set of tires, and make a run to Checkers here and try to put your name in the winner's circle at USA International. Royce Johnston down on the bottom side. That car fairly slow that time out of turn two. He's going to run up the racetrack just a little bit, but we can see some damage to the right front of that race car. Here is Keith Rogan along with Sean Studer, and looks like Studer going to be wedged in behind the 66 out of turn four.
Well, that was definitely racing, because they were rubbing out there. And I think back now to Shane Wallace's crew chief, Darren Shaw, is talking about we would like to come in and pit around lap 150. And then I always start chuckling, because you know what? You don't want to pit on lap 150 if the green flag is still out. You have to wait, and it is a nail biter once you get many more laps into this race, because then you begin to impinge on the fuel window. The tires are definitely going away, and you're just hoping and praying for a caution so you can come in and make it better without losing any track, without losing a lap at least. Certainly you lose track positions.
We've seen seven cautions so far to this point in the race. There's Don Satterfield down on the bottom side as Joe Gaeta will size him up and go to the outside. Seven cautions already so far in the race. Now you got to wonder, will everybody kind of settle down, get that first race of New Year jitters taken care of, and a long green flag run could really leave some of these leaders in trouble if they don't get that caution.
Don Satterfield awarded the Humanitarian Award, voted by his peers as the man who got that award for his work, of course, in donating to the Victory Junction gang. And you know, anybody that knows Don Satterfield knows he's a nice guy. We just made it official at the banquet at the end of the 2002 season. Well, actually just the start of 2003, the banquet held in Atlanta in January. Don Satterfield goes a lap down to the two leaders, Joe Gaeta and the number four of Shane Wallace out of Mooresville, North Carolina. Another slow-moving car around the bottom of the track.
Tony Amico's car, the 07, yep. A damage to the right front of that race car. Doesn't want to turn very well. Have to bring that car to pit road. The Caddy's Beach Bar Chevrolet. He's from over at Clearwater, just about an hour's drive from USA International Speedway on the west coast of Florida. That car very slow right now, trying to make its way back to the pit road.
So he's going to have to pit under green. It looks like he's headed that way. At least they'll be able to make adjustments and probably get him back out there without losing too many laps. He needs a quick caution to minimize the damage to his run here tonight. Gata needs no help at all. He would like to see this thing stay green for a little while longer, because his car is just fine. They go around the number 61 of J.P. Morgan out of Ether, North Carolina, the crewschool.com. Phil Morgan Pottery, Monte Carlo.
Looks like they fixed that right front fender where they had some trouble.
And Tony Amico is not going to get around. That's going to bring out the caution. He is just about moving, and now he's just about stopped.
This is exactly what those leaders wanted. They've gotten past halfway, now a chance to come down pit road under caution, refuel the cars, and put tires on the race car.
Next five races on the schedule begin with Five Flags Speedway in Pensacola. As you mentioned, Gene, we go to New Smyrna. Then up north to Jennerstown as the Northern Division gets underway. The Southern drivers go to Ace Speedway in Altamaha and Lonesome Pine Speedway in Coburn, Virginia, also a Northern Division race. All the information about Hooters Pro Cup racing can be had at usarprocup.com on the World Wide Web. Visit it often. Find out everything you need to know. Join us as many times as you can during the season at the racetracks and, of course, here on Speed.
Now you can see those drivers that are ready to come to pit road start to drop down. They've reached the drop-down point as indicated in their driver's meeting. They'll drop down, advance to the pace car, and get set to come to pit road and service down on the pit road to get those cars ready for the final run here.
Pole sitter Stacy Puryear down there. Also Toby Porter in the 16, the 7 of Mike Laughlin Jr., the 8 of Andrew Medlin in the Anico Electric Construction Ford. Here you can see all the pit stop action in our triple screen. And Amico getting a push from one of the service cars, the service pickup truck there. Leader Joe Gata right behind the flashing yellow lights, heading for his pit stall. He picked up the halfway leader prize money, and now he's headed towards Doug Rice.
Very important pit stops coming up for the race leaders. First into the pits, Joe Gata in the 06. He is going to get four tires here. They're also going to put a strip of tape across the front. They say the car is running a little bit too cool. Things seem to be going okay so far on this stop. Right in front of Gata is the second place running car of Shane Wallace. Shane is also going to go for a four tire stop, and they'll top off the fuel tank, and hopefully he can get out a little bit quick. And up on up the pit lane in front of them is Stacy Puryear. He is the pole sitter for tonight. This is Puryear's stop. Shane Wallace, he is down and away. He will beat Joe Gata out of the pits. Gata now has his left side tires on. He got the tape on the grill. He's out, and Stacy Puryear has also cleared the pit lane.
So pretty uneventful on pit road, but not for Sean Studer. He's run out of gas on the racetrack. That is a big problem. Welcome back to our Lucas Oil race recap. In case you're just joining us, here's what's happened up to now. We started out under green and yellow for 15 laps to finish up drying the racetrack. After a rain delay, it pushed the start back by a couple of hours. So the race cars went out to get the last of the moisture off the track. On lap 16, it was the green flag waving. Guy Hamby doing the honors. He is also the crew chief on the naturally fresh hot air balloon, which is on site. And once the race got underway, things began to happen fast. The pole sitter was Stacy Puryear, who lost the lead on lap number 23 to Mario Gosselin, who started outside row number one. Gosselin, a familiar face not only here at USA International, but at Hooters Pro Cup Racing too. The number four of Shane Wallace moving into position, and he would be the next to strike. On lap number 49, Gosselin losing spots, Wallace coming by underneath, the handle going away on Mario Gosselin's number 10 race car, and Shane Wallace enjoyed a long run at the front of the field, all the way up to lap 109, when Joe Gata, who started outside row number two, slid by on the inside in the number 06 Kimnock Ford entry. Gata, veteran driver officially this year after running 2002 as a rookie. And then on lap number 138, past the halfway mark, Gata had stayed out for the halfway honors, and Shane Wallace came in with mechanical problems, so a tremendous run, and the number four car came to an end. That brings us up to speed here with our Lucas Oil race recap. Tough break for Shane Wallace. Man, he looked good out there tonight. And then one of those little nuts or bolts, one of those little pieces, parts.
Actually,
went bad
it was
on
two,
it.
Brian. Two of the lugs on the right front, apparently the studs on that hub broke. Of course, that's a dangerous situation. You don't want to go out there with having lug nuts that are loose, and you particularly don't want to go out there missing some of those studs, those lugs that are bolted to.
I'm fascinated by what you're telling me, but look at this. On board with Michael Rich, and you've got a whole windshield full, if you're hanging off the back, of Mario Gosselin's number 10 car coming at you.
The only dodge of the field being pressured by Mario Gosselin. You can see Don Satterfield down on the bottom of the racetrack. That Hawk Sawblade Chevrolet stays downstairs as those two leaders go at it back into the corner.
So Rich able to put a little bit of distance in between himself and Gosselin. The 97 of Danny Salmon's running in third position. Salmon's having a not altogether uneventful run here tonight. We saw him with some difficulties, but he has recovered nicely after going down to pit road, making the adjustments he needed. The three of them have pulled away from the field. Gosselin challenging for the lead with Salmon's right behind him.
Mario's had a handful of that race car all night long, has to pitch it a little bit coming up off the corner, continues to challenge Rich, and here's Salmon's trying to open up the door, stay on the bottom side and make a run at Michael Rich as well.
So for the second time tonight, Mario Gosselin leads, using those big brawny arms to wrestle his race car out in front right now. Danny Salmon's coming into second position. Doug Rice has caught up with a very disappointed Shane Wallace.
I thought there was a good chance we might be talking to Shane Wallace in victory lane tonight, but Shane, you're back here behind the wall.
Yeah, you know, we had a really strong car, you know. Came in, took four tires there. We beat them all out of the pits, had a great pit stop. The boys did a great job tonight. Dan, my crew chief, did an absolute job. I mean, we had a race car. I thought we were really going to win this race tonight. And under caution, getting ready to go back green, they said right front chain, you're seeing two broken studs on the right front. And it's too big of a risk to hurt our own car and for me to get hurt or to hurt somebody else on the racetrack. So we did the smart thing, and we'll pull it off the racetrack tonight, and it's still in one piece. And we'll be back at Pensacola. I'm sure we can win that one too.
I can only guess that the wrench, the air wrench, was just twisting a little too hard on a couple of those nuts. Maybe they were compromised in some way beforehand, but you know what? They were right there, broken off, pretty much flush with the wheel. That's where the pressure is when you're cranking on them with an air wrench.
Absolutely, and a smart move. Although they have served notice, they're going to be a strong race car. We were back on board just for a few moments with David Stover out of Tulsa, Oklahoma. He'll be a rookie this season in the Southern Division, carrying that onboard camera for Shaw Industries here in this event down the back straightaway. Here is the 92 of Nesbitt trying to challenge the 94 of Keith Rogan. Rogan stayed out, did not come to pit road. We also see Luke Hill, who has moved up as well in the 41.
Hadn't really called his number, and they have out of Safety Harbor, Florida. Luke Hill, the number 41. Our Goodyear full field rundown is going to show you where everybody's running, including Bill Plemons Jr. rounding out the top 10 in the Hooters car. The 94 you're looking at is that of rookie Keith Rogan. And you can see that the round of pit stop shuffled thing up a little bit. Sean Studer, who we saw briefly run out of gas on the racetrack, lost a lap. So Sean Studer, who had a very strong run up among the leaders, is now a lap down, and he'll be trying to get it back in the second half of this race. And we go all the way back to the drivers who have had mechanical difficulties, including now Shane Wallace. As we look at the entire Goodyear full field rundown, 36 cars. We mentioned that Larry Barrett did not take the start. There were 37 eligible to begin the race here tonight. Only 36 took the green.
Now, Larry Barrett took time at time trials. The car seemed like the motor started to lay down on him about halfway through the first qualifying lap, and probably a smart move to go ahead and load it up. Danny Samich, a challenge for the lead down in turn number three. Mario Gosselin stays on the high side, and Danny Samich shows that this young man has gone to school, learned his lessons well, and is able to put his car back up front.
So Danny Salmons takes the lead for the first time here tonight. Salmons edges past Mario Gosselin, who continues to have some handling problems, and the two of Steven Christian, the Lucas Oil Blacks Tire Service number two, to be specific, is in third position now. So they've made the adjustments they wanted to during the round of pit stops, and now it appears as though Christian has got the car to beat out there tonight.
Shane Huffman also stepping it up in that Ford, the 84 Geneo Turkey Store Ford, closing in to make it a four-car freight train up front.
We saw Huffman go around without a caution flag, so he just flat spotted some tires and then got a quick caution. Bill Plemons and Mike Laughlin Jr. just gets it stopped in time to avoid what could have been a much more serious accident there. A broadside hit on Plemons amounts to nothing more than some skid marks on the racetrack.
Doesn't look like Mike Laughlin is able to refire that car. Bill Plemons, that's the worst position to ever get yourself in, to be looking outside that driver window. Just turn your head to the left and see that oncoming traffic, doing all you can to get the car refired. Thankfully, Laughlin able to lock down the brakes and stop the car in time.
That gives us an opportunity to take a break as some of the fans are on their feet for what might have happened. It didn't, and we'll be right back. Welcome back to Hooters Pro Cup Racing here on Speed. You'll see us all season long with great action like this as we go back to green. Lap number 160, 90 laps from the finish of this one. We're racing again behind Danny Sammons in the number 97. Although Mike Laughlin Jr. is giving him a shove down underneath. Got him just loose enough to get his lap back.
Well, that's
nice job.
That's because Mike Laughlin Jr. lost a lap when he locked down those binders just as we went to break to get stopped at before hitting Plymouth's. He lost a lap. He's now got it back, but he's the distance of the racetrack behind.
Let's take a look at the Coca-Cola replay as he goes down underneath. Then he stands on the gas pedal with that big size 13 shoe, the same one he used to stand on the brakes that lost him the lap, got it back. So he's out in front right now and looking for another quick caution so he can rejoin the tail end of the field. Danny Sammons is not really challenging him, doesn't have to. He's more worried about the cars behind him, including Stephen Christian, who's taken over the number two spot.
And the third car behind them, the 71 of Sean Studer, similar situation. Remember, he ran out of gas earlier in the evening. He's lost a lap. He's trying to get back in the lead lap. He's got to get by these two cars, Sammons and Christian, to have an opportunity to come all the way around the racetrack if we get a caution and line up at the tail end of the field.
Your leader is Danny Sammons, who will run in the Northern Division for the bulk of the season. But he's coming down here in the French Trailer Service Hallmark.com entry to get, you know, the butterflies out, get the jitters over with. Everybody else he's racing against will be up north in their first race, while Danny will have one under his belt. Likewise, Derek Kelly will race up north. He's out of the race here tonight, but he will have had one under his belt. A little bit of wiggle wobble in there behind the wheel of the number 25 car of David Stover, and we'll take a break. Welcome back to USA International Speedway. Danny Sammons out in front and not really being challenged particularly right now by Stephen Christian, who's found a big empty spot on the racetrack, about three quarters of a second behind. And in third spot it is, the 71 of Studer, who is a lap down. Let's go downstairs to Doug Rice. He's got a little more on the driver behind the wheel of the 97.
Brian and Gene, this is a copy of Area Auto Racing News, one of the many newspapers that strictly covers motorsports in the United States. The publisher of Area Auto Racing News is Lynn Sammons. Lynn Sammons is the crew chief and also happens to be the dad of Danny Sammons, the young man that's leading the race here at Lakeland. He has promised if Danny hangs on and wins the race, he'll adorn the cover of the next edition of Area Auto Racing News.
Well, at least he can make good on that promise. Some guys would say, well, I'll get you on the cover of the Rolling Stone. Remember that song? Well, we can get him on the cover of the Area Racing News if Danny Sammons stays out there, no problem. Dad publishes the paper. Coming up behind the 72 of Mikey Stafford, who we saw have a problem earlier in the race. He's back out on the racetrack, as is the number three of Mike Strother, Star Motorsports Pontiac, we're correctly calling it now, has managed to make some repairs. Way down in the running order, but he's still out on the racetrack. On board once again.
Whoa,
with
hang on, Stover.
Oh, that was close. And now he stalled the race car. See the red light on the dash? And all the dials down against the peg? He's trying to get it started, but he's not going to do it. We would normally call that a near miss, although George Carlin would call it a near hit. And we are under caution now for debris on the racetrack, we're hearing over the radios from USAR officials. And a break for the 25 car of Stover. Doggone near stove in the front of his car on the end of pit wall.
That'll get your attention in a hurry.
So Danny Sammons will lead again, and Mike Laughlin Jr. definitely got his opportunity to rejoin the back of the field.
It's a brand new season, so it must mean there are some new rules. And indeed there are this year, and they involve the car's greenhouse. Now, we're not talking about the kind of greenhouse where you grow plants, but we're talking about the roof line of the 2003 model USAR Pro Cup cars. If you run a 2003 car, you must run this new roof line package. Now, it's made out of a composite material constructed by Laughlin Racing Products. So when you see some of the newer cars out on the track, say for instance, Stacy Puryear or Shane Huffman, and maybe their roof packages look a little bit different, it's because they're running the new and approved roof line. And by the way, they all look universal. The only difference between a roof package for a Chevy, Ford, or a Dodge is the Opera windows. They are slightly different. Everything else is identical. And by the way, they are tamper-proof. You must run them exactly how they come out of the factory for the 2003 season. And that tops off our story about roof lines.
All right, thanks to Doug Rice. At least USAR changes their rules at the end of the season and not at the end of every race.
Well, Brian, that rule really came about to try to help teams as far as expenses. This entire body package is built so that they've got a flange-fit body.
Three
lot of action
on the restart. Studer down on the inside trying to get his lap back. He's getting a little squirrely. Look at this. Contact between Sammons and Christian, and Studer hits the wall a ton. Takes out the leader, Sammons, too. He continues around the racetrack, but Sean Studer is done for the night. Stick a fork in the Carl Buttig Meats entry. It is done. He is moving around inside the car and gets the net down. So the driver's okay and the safety crew is over there. Let's take another look at that one. Oh, man.
Looked like Studer and Sammons may have got together. Maybe have some contact with Christian. Steve definitely came down, and out of the car comes Sean Studer. That's good to see.
Well, that was exciting. Stay tuned for more, maybe. Well, take a deep breath and enjoy the Naturally Fresh Foods 250 presented by Advanced Discount Auto Parts here as we have had a major crash and a major development. Let's go downstairs and talk to the driver.
Sean, you were involved in a crash on a restart a moment ago. First of all, you took a pretty hard lick. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. It's just a shame. We had a great car tonight. We had a misfortune. I don't know how we ran out of fuel when we can't. We're ready to come. I mean, we were ready to come in and pit. The Carl Buttig Pulse Chevrolet Monte Carlo was just running great. I had a chance there that I could get a lap back, and an opening occurred right there, and I stuck my nose in there. And then Danny Sammons and drifted up into Stephen Christian, got him crossed up, and then that brought Danny Sammons back down onto me and clipped me. And then I came around just racing hard to get my lap back. So, it's a shame that it happened, and I'm sorry I tore up anybody else's race car. It's just hard racing and trying to be careful when you're in those tight quarters and you don't give an inch for each other. So the Carl Buttig Chevrolet Pulse, Chevrolet Automotive Specialist Motors are great. Billy Hess Cars, thank you very much. We'll be back at it again. Thanks.
Sean Studer definitely used up that race car, but he had to go downstairs to try to get that lap back. That's only good racing. Had a strong race car, made it work for the most part. Then it came to a short end just before turn number three.
Well, Doug Rice now has caught up with the crew chief on the number 97 car. Danny Sammons somewhat collected in that incident. Here's Doug.
Danny Sammons meets misfortune out on the track. Tommy Bear, what's he saying about the car now? It looks pretty bad on the rear end.
He said the car's fine. He said it might be a little bit, knocked the toe out of it a little bit. And the rear end damage isn't hurting anything. It's not rubbing anything. Just the car got underneath us and slid up into us and pushed us into Christian there. And the car should be fine. We're just trying to ride it out, see how good it is.
Okay, so we get ready to go back to the green. Stephen Christian, who was somewhat and slightly involved in that incident, is your new leader, restarting on lap 202 with Joe Gaeta right behind him. And then the 84 is right behind them, Shane Huffman's Genio Turkey Store car.
Remember, he's recovered from a spin out of turn two just after going back to green after pit stops prior to halfway. Went around with that race car. He's moved it back up to third per year, running in fourth right behind him. But Chevrolets and Fords mixing it up right now as they head down there.
Okay, well, you can say that the green has sort of risen to the top once again. Consider Stacy Puryear is right there in the picture. So a lot of the cars that started up front lost and swapped positions for a while during the early going, but now their crews have brought them back to the front for the race here as we look at our Goodyear full field rundown and continue to do so. Up underneath is Puryear moving into third spot, and we see the orange nose of Mario Gosselin's car on the front five who've opened up a bit of a gap on everybody else.
Looks like Gosselin has got everything mounted up. Once again, he gets into the back of Huff, but just briefly, they'll straighten it out and continue on. Pretty good run. Let's get down trackside. Doug Rice has caught up to Mike Hester.
Mike, can you guys hold him at bay and win this thing?
I don't know. Gator's pretty strong tonight. Stephen's giving all he's got. We'll wait and see.
You guys have been on again and off again, it seems like, tonight.
Yeah, we just played it smooth through these traffic, let the laps run down.
All right, we'll see if Stephen Christian can hold off Joe Gator in the closing laps here tonight at Lakeland.
I'm going to take a little bit of stock in what Mike Hester said. Gator is strong tonight. That is somewhat obvious to us, but you know that those sharp-eyed guys on the top of the pit boxes down there know who's fast and who's not, because they got watches on everybody.
Well, the RBR folks have been strong here at Lakeland. The past year and a half, Jason Service behind the wheel of the 22 and got the job done many times here going to Victory Lane. Steve Christian himself, no stranger to Victory Lane here at USA International Speedway, but he's got a lot of hunger right behind him. Joe Gator wants a win notched in that little column over there beside his name. Goslin's going to lose a spot to Mike Laughlin Jr. And Goslin's car really seeing the handle go away. Matt Carter will go to the inside. Now Bill Clements Jr. able to drive to the bottom side. So Mario Goslin, just as quickly as they found the handle, looks like things have gone south.
Chad Mullis also down inside. Goslin definitely has a problem. Stephen Christian's problem is mainly Joe Gator. Christian's only win last year came at Peach State, but yes, he's very familiar with this racetrack. Gator looking for his first ever career win in Hooters Pro Cup Racing, and we've got lots of good action going on behind them as Toby Porter has very quietly maintained his position among the top four or five race cars, and he's got a good one going back there with the pole sitter for this one, the number 11 of Stacy Puryear, the Bryan Heating and Cooling Chevy Monte Carlo.
Porter made short work of Shane Huffman in the 84 car to step up, but now challenge and get around. Puryear for third. Gator again putting the pressure on, trying to challenge Steve Christian, who is up front with car number two.
Porter moving around per year, and those four cars are now among the leaders. Goslin had made it five and was sliding back. Actually, Porter came forward to join the lead group as well. So a lot of shuffling in positions here, and you can see there's a lot of real estate at USA International between the first five cars and everybody else. So these are the contenders for the closing laps of the Naturally Fresh Foods 250.
Here's Luke Hill, car number 41, trailing the Laughlin car, the number seven. Luke Hill had a strong run towards the end of the championship series at Peach State Speedway. Only to see it go away about halfway, just past halfway there. And how about, nonetheless, looking for a good run here tonight.
Oh, and how about Mike Laughlin Jr. goes from a lap down to a battle for seventh, and that is one heck of a deal. Look at this, four wide with some lap cars if you count them. Gator down inside trying to stay there. Porter trying to use the high line to make something happen. And Stephen Christian wishes he was driving something about as wide as a golf cart mowing machine. Welcome back to Hooters Pro Cup Racing on Speed. During the break, we had a change for the lead. We're going to show it to you as Joe Gator goes down inside on Stephen Christian. Gator's had a good handling race car all night. You heard Christian's crew chief Mike Hester say he was fast and we're worried about him for good reason. They battled side by side for a while, but eventually Joe Gator is able to take the position with Toby Porter trying to take advantage. Couldn't quite follow him through.
Leaders have caught up to some lap traffic. Here is Don Satterfield and Tony Amico, along with Mikey Stafford, several other cars out on the bottom side as they'll go to the outside and work their way around as 223 laps are on the board. There's your Naturally Fresh Foods summary. Wind it down here in the first event of 2003.
Toby Porter did eventually follow Gator past Stephen Christian, and you can see that they are the two cars running 1-2 right now, and just under a second covers the top three. Joe Gator out in front, looking good with very few laps remaining in this race for his first ever career victory at Hooters Pro Cup Racing. And there is Don Satterfield in the Hawk Saw Blades number one, a lapped car. They also go around another lapped entry there, the 66 of Royce Johnston, moving up somewhat slowly around the racetrack. The interval's closed up a little bit as Toby Porter has definitely taken about half the gap to Joe Gator away.
But the top two have broken away from the rest of the field, set to try to decide it amongst themselves here tonight. And Toby Porter, I was talking to Red down in the pit area, said that Haskell called him. Red was out on the tractor, the bulldozer there. He is Irmo Grading, the sponsor on the side of that race car. He was on a bulldozer at noontime Friday afternoon, got the phone call, got a shower, grabbed some clothes, and they went racing. It looks like it's paid off so far. A second place run, see if he can get by Joe Gator here as the laps wind down.
Haskell the Rascal Willingham. Anybody that knows him understands why he got that nickname, not just because it rhymes. Gata now stretching out maybe an extra half car length on Porter there, and it turns into 0.8 seconds. Doesn't take long for a tenth of a second or two to tick away on the clock here at this kind of speed.
Porter's car is getting a little bit loose that time, the middle of the corner and the exit. You can see the car try to jump sideways on him, so he's having to really ease onto that throttle coming up off the corner. There's Steve Christian and Stacy Puryear getting together there.
Yeah, Christian's got his hands full with Puryear for third, and Joe Gata, if he can't see it himself, you know his crew is telling him, that car behind you is a little bit loose, so just hang on and drive like you're driving. He doesn't have anything for you, at least not yet, at least not now.
Like Keith Rogan off the pace down on the bottom side. He may be rolling to pit road. There is the 94, the Southern Road Builders Chevrolet for rookie Keith Rogan. Rounding out your top five is Shane Huffman. Huffman. Yep. Very quiet race for Huffman, uneventful for a first race out. That's almost what you want. If you can't be up front and have a chance to win the race, bring a car home in one piece so you go to the next one and get all your ducks in a row, use it as a learning experience.
Rogan's crew goes under the hood of the 94 to see if they can fix the problem, get him back out there for as many points as possible. Meanwhile, Gata just strolling right now as Porter works down inside, and he has not gotten any closer. Going past another lapped automobile.
And they just put Michael Rich a lap down, so they only dodge the field now. After leading some laps early on, just past the halfway point, he will go down one lap. Looks like it may be terminal for Keith Rogan.
Especially because the crew appears to be searching for a mystery and have very few clues. Over a second now, the gap between Gata and Porter right now, so things are getting better in Joe Gata. His stock is rising in terms of picking up a first victory. Christian still with his mirror full of pole sitter Stacy Puryear.
As you can see, 14 cars remain on the lead lap.
And the 84 still circulating. Pretty much, as you said, a very quiet evening for Shane Huffman, the Genio Turkey Store Ford Taurus. He doesn't have anybody to race with at this point in the competition. That's both good and bad. For sure, he's not in danger of losing a top five finish here tonight, but I'm sure he would prefer to have a car that was a tenth or two faster every lap. There's the lap car of Don Satterfield, the number one Hawk Saw Blades entry. Satterfield among the cars high up in the order of those cars lapped down. Satterfield running in about 17th position right now. And here's the man that's got the run of the night, I think, Mike Laughlin Jr., who stood on the brakes so hard he doggone near bent the pedal down to the floorboard, then stood on the gas hard enough to get his lap back, and he's all the way up to seventh.
Right behind him, Andrew Medlin, who is in a backup car. And again, he never even got half a lap. It wasn't his fault. He had a car come off the racetrack and collect his primary car. The Friday afternoon, safety tech inspection down on pit road. He was all smiles. He was pumped and ready to go racing, and it went away in less than half a lap. They've got the backup car together, and he's inside the top 10, looking for a top 10 finish here tonight. A great call to Andrew Medlin and the team for getting that car back together and everything back on track.
Seven car running seventh, the eight car running eighth. Chad Mullis in the nine car. They've lined up in numerical order out there on the racetrack. There's Bill Plemons Jr. in the Hooters number 15. He had a near-miss incident, too. The 92 inside of him, Martin Nesbitt, again, the unfamiliar 92 for Nesbitt.
And right behind them, the 02 of Danny O'Quinn Jr. Great run for the rookie. This is his first outing in one of these 3,300-pound steel-bodied race cars. He's been running late model stock and doing a great job here tonight in a potential position to pick up maybe a top 10 or just outside it. That's an outstanding way to start your Pro Cup Series career.
An excellent run indeed. And Matt Carter, likewise, in the 23, also running up there with a shot at a top 10 finish. There's the 72 and 77 of Mikey Stafford and Doug Stevens, both of whom are not on the lead lap.
And here's Danny Sam as they repaired the race car. He's back out to complete some laps. We'll be back for the finish of the Naturally Fresh Foods 250 in just a moment.
Laps winding down at USA International Speedway with Joe Gata out in front. Coming up behind the number 61 of J.P. Morgan, rookie driver in the CrewSchool.com car, trying to stay on the lap that he's on right now, but he's going to lose another one. They're also coming up behind now the 80 of Brian Finney. We haven't seen much of him in the Bob Steele Chevrolet Monte Carlo. But there is Joe Gata, who looks very strong in trying to pick up his first ever career win at Hooters Pro Cup Racing. He had a strong rookie season last year, but without a victory, and he has put Toby Porter far enough behind where if he just keeps pedaling, he'll see that checkered flag that he's been looking for.
Now, Toby Porter does have a win to his credit in the Pro Cup Series. That came, I think it was back about 2000 in Greenville, South Carolina. But it's not because he doesn't want to win tonight's race. Joe Cada is just that strong here tonight with 10 laps remaining.
Inside the final 10 laps now, Cada coming up on some more traffic. His major issue right now is just to stay out of trouble and keep his head on a swivel out there, look for any potential danger or potential damage to his chance of winning the race. He goes around Tony Amico again, and Amico still having a pretty good, strong run in the top 20 despite problems here tonight.
Danny Sammons right on the bottom side there. Mikey Stafford up on the outside.
Talk to Gato about his goals for the season.
Yeah, I mean, you know, one of our goals last year was to win a race and win a pole, which wound up winning the pole, but we just didn't get that race. So this year we're hoping to come back. So we'd like to start the season off right and get that win on the first race down here at Lakeland. You know, it'd mean a lot to us, but we'll see. The crew's worked real hard. The car's fast. We were fastest in practice, so we got a good car. If we can just get the job done, you know, we'll get that first win.
All right, it's the first race of the year. I promise not to bring this up again all season long, but obviously there was one down here that, when you look back at it, that maybe you could have had a trophy here in Lakeland.
Well, I mean, without wrecking Bobby Gill, we could have had a trophy, but it was just a good race. We were both racing hard. We made some contact, and, you know, Bobby won. He's a good driver. We can't, you know, we're certainly not taking anything from him. If I could have won it, I would have, but I'll tell you, you know, he just beat us at the start-finish line. But I believe today is going to be our day. The ACS Chemnot Ford Taurus, man, that thing is running great today, you know. I'd like to thank our sponsors, Town Bank, Building Specialties, Racetrap.com, Tidewater Interior Products. You know, they've all come on board again with us this year, and we believe we're going to get some wins for them.
So before the race ever starts, Joe Gata gets a chance at a dress rehearsal for the interview after it's done.
It doesn't look like
anybody's got anything for him here as we get to five laps remaining here at USA International, 3/4 of a mile apiece. And Joe Cada will have his first win. He comes up behind the Jasper entry number 77, Doug Stevens, out of Lovejoy, Georgia, the Jasper Engines Transmissions Ford Taurus. Stevens running just outside the top 20 at the moment per year, still nudging on the back bumper of Stephen Christian, and that is for third and fourth.
Joe Cada here, heavy traffic directly ahead. Now, Joe Cada, that entire team, they only have one race car. They ran the entire 2002 campaign, and they're starting this year with that race car. They've got some cars under construction. They're nowhere near ready to come to the racetrack, but Cada, with a single race car in the stable, has been able to be a strong horse all season long in 2002, and very strong here in the opening race of 2003. Per year, not giving up, still trying to get around Steve Christian.
Christian putting the do not pass sign everywhere he can out there on the racetrack as Cada comes into traffic behind the 92 of Martin Nesbitt. Nesbitt looking to try to stay on the lead lap here, but he's going to go a lap down inside the final five and running in 13th position. Not a bad run for the Coca-Cola entry. Here we go to the battle once again for third as Purrier's having another run going in to the corner on Stephen Christian, who's doing a great job of mirror driving him around the track and trying to hang on for a podium position here tonight. Meanwhile, Joe Cada puts Nesbitt a lap down, and he'll get the white flag as he does so. Well, not yet. Now he pulls up alongside and nudges across the finish line with one lap to go, putting Nesbitt a lap down, goes around the 66 of Royce Johnston. He's got some clear track in front of him with Bill Plemons a few car lengths ahead. Plemons will see the move over flag. He already has, and it looks like Joe Cada is going to take the Chemnot Ford to victory lane here and pick up that first ever Hooters Pro Cup victory. His crew naturally celebrating on pit wall, and it's a done deal.
Do you think they're happy?
Well, you know, when it takes a while to get that first one, it's so special. And maybe the longer it takes, the more special it is. They went a whole season without a victory, but now they've got the one they were looking for.
You know, I sat down before this season got underway and made a list of drivers that I expected to see in the victory circle, and Joe Cada was among those at the very top, and right off the bat, he's made it happen.
Well, when we did our preview review show, it was a consensus among Bobby Gill, Jason Sarvis, and Stephen Christian. Joe Gata's name popped up first as a guy they'd be looking for in 2003 to have to beat in order to get a win themselves. Cada goes to victory lane in the first race of the season, starts off 2003 with he'll be atop the charts as the points leader as well.
First drivers in 2 years to go to victory lane in the Pro Cup Series here at USA International Speedway that did not have the name Jason Sarmers or Bobby Gill. So a new face in victory lane in at USA International Speedway this race.
Gate is going to light it up for the crowd here tonight with a pretty nice burnout effort there. And he pulls into victory lane for the honors. We'll be back and show all that to you in a minute.
USAR Hooters Pro Cup Racing has been brought to you by Hooters, the cure for the common restaurant. Naturally fresh salad dressing. Look for it in your supermarket's produce section. Miller Lite. Miller Lite is the official sponsor of the USAR Hooters Pro Cup Series. Lucas Oil Products. Lucas Oil Products is a leader in heavy-duty and high-performance lubricants.
Joe Gata climbing out of the ACS Systems and Engineering Kim Nock Ford in victory lane, and you can see the expression of happiness on his face. Doug Rice is down there to hear from him.
Joe, congratulations. First off, you came so close to winning here last year. You come back and you start the 2003 season in the best of all possible ways.
Yeah, I'll tell you, man, I just thank God for this win. You know, Book of Proverbs tells us, man prepares his horse for the day of battle, but victory comes from the Lord. So we thank the Lord for this victory. Man, I got a great team. Those guys worked hard. I tell you, my car owner don't give us nothing but first-class stuff. I thought it was just a matter of time, and, man, we finally got it.
And this was not an easy race. There at the end, Toby Porter raced you hard, and throughout the whole evening you had to battle to stay up toward the front.
Yeah, I mean, we definitely didn't lead the most laps. I mean, all those guys really had their stuff together. I mean, you know, it's a good race. It was a good, clean race, but you had to race hard to win it. All those guys were going as hard as they could on old tires. I mean, I knew like Steve Christian, you know, we had a little better tires than he did. And so I just took my time, and, you know, it was just a good race, man. Praise the Lord.
You told me tonight, you said, we've got enough what it takes to win races this year, and you backed it up by starting out fast tonight.
Yeah, I mean, I got to admit, I got a lot of confidence in this team, a lot of confidence in the car owner. You know, they work hard, and we got some great sponsors in ACS, Kim Nock Ford, Town Bank, Tidewater Interior Products, Building Specialties, Racewrap.com. So, you know, it's just a great team all the way around, and, man, I hope we can just win a whole bunch more of them.
All right, Joe Gata was quoting scripture there just a moment ago, talking about you got to have the strong horse taking it into battle. And tonight, he rode his horse to victory here at Lakeland.
And it turns out he did lead the most laps, a total of 62, as we take a look at our results for the Naturally Fresh Foods 250. Gata, Toby Porter kind of lost because he was out all by himself while the great battle for third and fourth was going on between Christian and Puryear. Mike Laughlin Jr., how about that, from a lap down to sixth. Nice run for him. Michael Rich in 15th position. We saw him go a lap down late, as did Mark Nesbitt and Danny Sammons, who led the race earlier in the evening. Mario Gosselin, who started up front, slipped back to 16th by the time it was all done. And Don Satterfield finished right behind him. Mikey Stafford, nice run from deep in the field up to the position where he finished, and that was 18th. And that's probably going to make him our hard charger. We'll check on it real quick and let you know in a moment. David Stover, we rode with him for a while here tonight. Corey Rubel, another nice finish for a rookie. Todd Hirschfeld ran into problems late. And then we see where attrition took its toll. Derek Kelly, we heard from him. Billy Mowry having problems late in the race, too. Toby Porter, the runner-up, he's with Doug Rice right now, celebrating a great way to start the year.
If you're looking for a feel-good story at Lakeland tonight, you have to look no further than Toby Porter. Toby, what, 48 hours ago, you didn't even have a ride.
Yeah, they called me yesterday about 10:30 yesterday morning. Haskell did want me to drive his car, so he didn't have nobody driving. So it's been come together pretty quick here and had a pretty good finish, so pretty good deal.
So the day before the race, the car owner, Haskell Willingham, calls Toby Porter and says, hey, I need to put you in my car. You come down here to Lakeland, you race, you almost win the thing. You come home and finishing a strong second. That's quite a turnaround in 24 hours, Toby.
Yeah, it was. Yes, it was. Like I said, we got here this morning and had to put a seat in it and get everything ready inside of it, and missed a little bit of practice. But the car run good. Car run good all day. Kind of took it easy there at the beginning of the race and felt it out. And made a run at him there at the end with about 20 to go, but just didn't have nothing for him.
Well, congratulations on a great effort, and also congratulations landing a ride in the 16 car down here this week.
Thank you.
And indeed, congratulations to Mikey Stafford. Started 34th, finished 18th. That makes him our hard charger for the Hooters Pro Cup Series season opener here at USA International. Driver points are going to look a lot like the results for this one, with one out of one races done so far. Gata will go to round two as the points leader, and rookie Danny O'Quinn and Matt Carter will round out the top 10 in points because they rounded out the top 10 finishers here tonight. Our rookie of the race is Matt Carter, number 23, finished in ninth position. Let's go to Doug Rice with the man who finished third.
He hung around the front all night long, and when it was over, Stephen Christian comes home with a third place run. Pretty good effort tonight, Stephen.
Not bad. You know, for the first time out, I think we'll take it. We were real happy. This Lucas Oil team worked their tail off today. We were off a little bit in practice. We ran a little bit faster when we tested here, and we couldn't figure out why. And Mike Hester and the guys worked on it real hard, and they figured out a few things after practice before qualifying. Then we adjusted a little bit more in the race and made it better. I'm just excited about the year. These guys work hard. The communication is so good between them. My hat's off to Joe, man. He needed one, and he was the car to beat all day in practice today, too. So.
Looked like your car got a little bit better as the evening wore on. Is that the case?
It did, and then I wore it out trying to hold back Joe. But again, these guys just, they work so hard. And I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited about it. Even after a third-place run, you'd think you wouldn't be quite as excited as the guy that won, but I'm just looking forward to it. I think we're going to have a good year.
That was a great battle with you and Joe. Looked like you raced each other really clean.
You know, I went over before the race, and I told him, I said, Joe, you let me down. He said, what do you mean? I said, well, I had you pegged for the pole all day in practice, and you didn't get it. He said, okay, we'll try to make it up in the race. And I didn't like that idea, but he pulled it off anyway. So, but, you know, like I said, Joe's come close before, and he needed it. Good for him, and we're just looking forward to the year.
All right, Stephen Christian's pretty good spirit tonight, finishing third.
Four top three finishes in 2002. He's off to a great start to equal or better that record now. Our next race day, we told you about it earlier, reminding you that Pensacola, Florida, Saturday, March 15th at 7:30 p.m. It's the next time you can visit a Hooters Pro Cup race. Congratulations to Joe Gata's crew. Of course, he thanked him for their help in getting him to victory lane. SpeedTV.com on the World Wide Web for all the information about everything that races. And our congratulations to Joe Gata, who drove the 06 car to victory here tonight. We'll see a lot of him this season, no doubt about that. We hope to see a lot of you. For Gene Crane and Doug Rice, I'm Brian Drebber. So long, everybody.